The latest government figures show sales of new homes fell more than expected in July, and that makes this year on track to be the worst year for new home sales since 1963.
And that affects all of us, even if we're not in the housing market. CBS News business and economics correspondent Rebecca Jarvis is here to tell us more this morning. Rebecca, good morning.
Hey, guys, good morning.
So the new figures from the Commerce Department obviously are not good. Why do they continue to fall?
Well, I mean, ultimately here you have two basic factors involved. You have people and their confidence is low. The job market is weak, and then on top of that, you still have the foreclosure problem. On the good news side of things, however, builders, and this is good news for prices, not necessarily for construction workers, but on the good news side of things, builders are building fewer new homes. And the main thing is the market has to clear that inventory out, and then that can lift prices overall.
So that could be helpful. But when we look at, I mean, the economy is obviously a big part of it. This is a serious drop when we look at these numbers. And are we really rivaling numbers of the Great Depression?
Yeah, this is a shocker. New home sales are down 18% in the past 2 years. That's a bigger drop, like you said, Erica, than in the Great Depression. And just to put it into context, after the Great Depression, it took 19 years, almost two decades, to bring prices back to where they started beforehand.
With all these numbers going down, down, and down, the median price of a new home right now?
Well, it's down 6%. A new home's median price right now is $222,000, and that's actually higher than the median price of a home that's already been on the market, an existing home. But, you know, ultimately, you're going to pay a little more for that than an existing home.
You mentioned that, you know, this drop in some ways is good, obviously, for buyers as they have to clear out that market. It may not be great for construction workers. And that's really the importance of a new home to the economy, right?
Yeah, new homes, beyond just what we all pay and what we get for our homes, they create jobs. About three jobs are created from every new home construction. In addition to that, it creates about $90,000 in taxes. So when we talk about the problems in Washington with collecting money, well, this is one place, the housing market, where Washington could, if people were out buying new homes, collect more money.
Still not good, though, for our growth with no homes being built.
Well, it's not necessarily good for our growth, and we need to see homes be built in order to grow. But for people who are looking at new homes, the best advice out there is that mortgage rates are at near record lows right now. If you do think about buying in the market, remember, this is still local. We're looking at the national picture, but there are some localities where it might make more sense to buy. And in addition to that, think about holding on to it. Like I said, it took 19 years out of the Great Depression. If you hold the home for 5 to 10 years now, it makes sense to own.
And you're really going to have to hold it in most cases. You can't get rid of it in a lot of markets, even if you want to.
And that's the big thing. You can't go into a home purchase thinking you're going to flip it. Those days
long gone,
well behind us. But if you are going to live there, go ahead, Chris.
But those low mortgage rates are still not enough incentive for people to get in, huh?
Well, that's the thing. I mean, people have to think about two things, what they're going to pay for the home and mortgage rates, but also their job status. And that's a big problem.
All right. CBS's Rebecca Jarvis.
Thanks,
Rebecca,
guys.
Thanks. Good to see you again.